Welcome back to the Azure Enablement Show and our series on learning resources. I'm April Edwards, your host for the series. Now we'll continue our tour of resources ready to help you become a better Azure professional. So without further ado, let's head off to our first destination.
Coming up, we're going to Microsoft certifications.
Hello, my name is Sandra Marine, and I am part of the Microsoft Learning Organization. I am the go-to-market lead for Azure training and certifications.
When someone goes to certifications for the first time, what do they find there and how do they get started?
So you go to microsoft.com/certifications, and the first thing is to identify your business and career goals. And with that, you can get the associated role jobs on a specialization. This will allow you to find the right set of certifications for you or for your team. We have a variety of Microsoft certifications for Azure across fundamentals, role-based, and specialties. Some certifications are better for IT pros, some for developers, some for data and AI professionals, and some are actually good for different professions. So depending on your goals, you will have different options.
Why should IT pros look into certifications?
We have certifications that are designed specifically for IT pros to validate the skills they need to build, deploy, and manage on-premises, hybrid, or cloud infrastructure solutions.
How should an IT pro start when it comes to certifications?
For IT pros, we recommend the Azure Administrator Associate Certification as the first one. This is the starting point for every IT pro. After Azure Administrator, depending on what is your interest or your experience, you can go for Azure Security Engineer, Azure Stack Hub Operator, Azure for SAP Workloads Specialty, or you can go for expert level certifications like Azure Solutions Architect or DevOps Engineer.
Is there any content that IT pros should pay particular attention to?
Our Azure Administrator certification and training is key, is super important. All other Azure certifications for IT pros assume that you have a strong Azure Administrator skills, knowledge and experience. So make sure before even considering or trying to go after all the other IT pro certifications, always have your Azure Administrator in your certification plan as the first step.
What are some things that most IT pros might not know about certifications?
There are a couple of things that IT pros probably don't know about Azure certifications. First, if you're preparing for any Microsoft certification, there is a document that is key. It's your first place to go. It's called the Skills Outline Document, and you will find it in every certification and exam page. This document is important, is key to understand what knowledge domains are covered in an exam. So this is your must-go resource. And there is another resource that is very valuable, which is Microsoft Official Practice Test. We have for almost every exam, and it's a great trial run for the actual exam to feel what the experience is. And all the objectives for the exams are covered in practice tests. So you will find it's a very good resource to get prepared.
Our next stop is Instructor Led Training.
Hi, my name is James Seymour. I manage the Azure Apps and Infrastructure Technical Content Team.
When someone looks into instructor-led training for the first time, how do they get started?
Well, to get started in instructor-led training, I think the best thing to do is to go look for your local learning partner. They can really help you set up a learning path. They can customize training for whatever your needs are. They give you personal attention, and we also keep the content up to date so you know that everything you're getting from them is the latest and greatest.
Why should IT professionals seek out instructor-led training?
IT professionals should go to instructor-led training if they really want to learn the skills they need to do a job. These are courses that are taught by industry experts that have been Azure administrators or DevOps engineers or architects or whatever track that you're interested in. And instructor-led training course is there to provide you the skills you need to do that job.
How should IT pros get started with instructor-led training?
An IT professional should start by evaluating where they are in their learning journey, and their local learning partner can help them do that. There's pre-assessments that can help fit you into where you want to be, but it really depends on where you are in your career. If you're currently an administrator, you want to polish up your skills and maybe get certified, we have Azure Administrator. If you're a DevOps engineer or an architect, there's different tracks for whatever it is you want to do and what you want to learn. If you're new to the whole thing, or maybe new to the IT profession, you can start with the fundamentals. Or even if you're a seasoned professional that doesn't have a broad scope understanding of what Azure is, and there's so many services in Azure that we don't use every day, the fundamentals can really level that base and give you a great foundation for learning.
Are there any tips for IT pros around instructor-led training?
The biggest tip or trick that I would give to an IT professional that's looking to get into instructor-led training is to figure out where you are. Fundamentals is a great place to start because it gives you a broad base of knowledge to then hone in on what it is that you really want to focus on in Azure. Not everybody does everything in Azure. Such a big service. So there may be administrators, there may be architects, or maybe engineers. There's even specialty tracks like a course on SAP in Azure. So it depends on what you're looking for. You really should focus on the area that would help you do your job or maybe get the next job.
What is one thing that many IT pros might not know about instructor-led training?
I think the one thing that most IT pros don't know about instructor-led training is that they can get it in their local language. There's local instructors that speak your language, teaching the courses that you need, teaching you the skills that you need to do your job. Also, those instructors can customize those courses to really give you the customized skills or focus on those features or products that you need to do your business, to learn your skills and advance your career.
Next, we visit Microsoft Docs.
Hi, my name is David Berry. I'm a program manager in Microsoft Docs for Azure Developer Experiences.
Hi, I'm Ornella Altunian. I'm a content developer for Visual Studio and Visual Studio Code.
What is Microsoft Docs and how do you get started with it?
So Microsoft Docs are a one-stop shop for all Microsoft products and services. And this content is built by the product managers and engineers and content developers who actually build the product. So you really can't get more official than that. And if you go to our page, you'll see a documentation section. And this will bring up a huge product directory of all of the things we offer. For example, if you want to look at Azure, then you'll be taken to all of the Azure products. And each one of these has its own table of contents with a lot of content. So there's reference content, tutorials, quick starts, all of these different types of ways that you can learn. And so for products that have multiple versions, so for example, if we go to something like Visual Studio here, you'll see that if you click on any content, in the upper left-hand corner, you'll get a version picker. And so you'll be able to see that same content for multiple versions of the product.
What are some tips and tricks for using Microsoft Docs?
Something that a lot of people don't know about is that you actually can download our docs as a PDF. And where you do that is down here in the lower left-hand corner with this download PDF link. This is something I've used before when I've had a flight that I'm getting on or I'm not going to have Wi-Fi access. If there's a technology that I want to brush up on, I'll download the entire doc set as a PDF onto my tablet, and then I'll have some reading material for those times that I don't have Wi-Fi or connectivity. Another thing that a lot of people don't know about our docs is that all of our docs are open source, meaning that if you, as a member of the community, see something that's wrong, like a spelling or a grammatical error, or maybe you read something and you feel like, you know, this could be explained a little bit more clearly, you can actually go in and you can actually make that change yourself. And the way you do that is by going up here to the edit button once you're signed in to Docs. And that actually will take you to a page where you actually can edit the actual doc in Markdown right in the browser. You make your edits, those will go to the content developer that's responsible for the page. They'll look over those edits, within a couple of days, approve those edits, and then those will actually be part of the live doc set. And so this is a great way that if you want to, you know, help out the rest of the community by improving the docs, you actually can do that very easily right in the browser.
How does Microsoft Docs help IT professionals succeed?
So when I think about how does Docs help people succeed, if you look through our docs, through all of our quick starts on our tutorials, we have a lot of sample scenarios and a lot of sample code that are built in there. And those can get you experience actually building something with our products and our technologies. But they also can provide the basis for the things that you need to build yourself. You can take some of that sample code or some of those commands right out of the document and then use that to form your solution. And that really can speed up your success when using our products and using our docs.
Coming up, we visit GitHub.
Hi, everybody. My name's Dave Burneson. I'm a technical advocate with the GitHub and Azure DevOps team.
What is GitHub? What do people find there and how do they get started?
GitHub is the home for all of your DevOps tools. Everything from source control, security checks for your code, continuous integration and continuous deployment tools, and so much more. You can get started by going to the GitHub Learning Lab.
Why should IT pros go to GitHub as a learning destination?
IT pros should go to GitHub as a learning destination because in this day and age, you're probably provisioning all of your resources in the cloud, whether it's through Terraform or Azure Resource Manager templates and things like that. And those things are managed in exactly the same way that developers manage their source code. So if you go to GitHub and GitHub Learning Lab, you can learn all about managing source code, working with pull requests, setting up your continuous integration and continuous delivery workflows, all in one place.
How should an IT pro get started with GitHub?
An IT pro can get started with GitHub by leveraging both Microsoft Learn and GitHub Learning Lab and look for the modules that are specifically for your role to learn all about using GitHub for infrastructure as code and continuous integration and continuous delivery so that you can work together with your development team to deliver continuous value for your end users.
Are there any GitHub features IT pros should pay particular attention to?
IT pros should pay particular attention to these areas of GitHub, and these are relatively new. GitHub Actions allows you to automate your continuous integration and continuous delivery workflows, but it goes beyond that as well. You can automate other workflows in addition to that. But that is a key part of infrastructure as code in today's DevOps world.
What is one thing that many IT pros might not know about GitHub?
One thing that most IT pros don't know about GitHub is the continuous integration and continuous delivery tools that are now available in GitHub Actions, enabling you to do everything from infrastructure as code to working with your developers to deploy the solutions to dev environments, QA environments, production environments, all in one place.
I hope you've enjoyed our tour across Azure Learning Resources. If you're looking to engage with any of the resources we visited in this video, please check the text in this video's description. Enjoy your learning and see you next time.